Okay, friends, so for this last little bit of the homework, I wanted to go back and examine something that I mentioned in one of the videos, and I forget exactly where it was, but I mentioned you might be seeing a pattern. And then I think I even said, like, well, maybe not just yet. And then I never came back to that, and I realized as I was editing the videos, maybe this is a good place to come back to that. So what I'm going to do is, on the board behind me, I'm going to place all four of those distributions that we just came up with in the videos when we bought one or two or three or four birds, the four different sized flocks we could have. The board's not big enough to have the one you just created on a two, although the pattern we're about to see will apply to that one as well. So through the miracle of technology, I'm going to snap my fingers, and then behind me, you're going to see the four distributions. And there they are. Magic. You gotta kind of go circularly with me because I had to fit them on the board here. So that's the one bird case, the two bird case, the three bird case, and the four bird case. And then you can look at the five bird case on your homework to see how that is. Now in orange, this whole question is about the coefficients that we had to figure out as we went. Now, when we did the first case up here, you might not have thought that there were any coefficients, and we'll come back to that in a second. The first one that really showed up was this 2 that was here. As a matter of fact, it showed up first on your second project. But we realized that 2 had to be there because that was the number of ways you could either have, I think it was Nancy be a girl and Marge be a boy, or Nancy be a boy and Marge be a girl. So there were two ways we had to figure out to arrange that. It showed up again, a similar kind of coefficient idea showed up down here in these last, these two middle probabilities here, 3 and 3, and that was we had 3 girls and had to arrange 1 or 2 of them as girls. And this was the really interesting one over here, this 6. That was fun. We had to, and I bet you felt something similar when you did question 2 on your homework with, if you've got 5 birds, how many ways can you have 2 or 3 of them to be girls? And you know, it takes some thinking. You have to kind of like, okay, so if I've got 5 and then I've got 2, how can I pair them off? Well, as it turns out, a couple things to think about. First of all, there are actually coefficients on every single probability, not just the ones that I've got in orange here. As a matter of fact, I mentioned these in the videos. All the other ones technically have a coefficient of 1, even up here, even up there, because there's only one way for each of those to happen. It's not super exciting, but you know, if you buy 4 birds, there's only one way that they can all be female. So it's still a coefficient. But what I want you to look at now is just the coefficients, because here's the deal. Here's the deal. If you ignore the coefficients, which are a big part of the binomial distribution, which we're going to start with on the beginning of day 2 of this topic, if you ignore the coefficients and just look at the probabilities are fairly straightforward. I think you can see that. Exponents that we use, even the ones you don't see, which are given a value of 1, right? All these ones that don't have anything on them are equal to 1, because that's the way coefficients or exponents work. You probably noticed that the exponents in each case sum to the number of birds in each case. So all the exponents in each of these probabilities sum to 4. All these sum to 3. All these sum to 2. This is not magical or tricky at all. It makes perfect sense because each of the birds in each of the lines is either a 0.1 or a 0.9 depending on whether it's male or female. So that shouldn't surprise anybody. And since we covered the idea of multiplication probabilities in that second project pretty deeply actually, I don't think that's going to cause a problem. The interesting thing is the coefficients themselves. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the magic of technology again, snap my fingers, and only focus on the coefficients. Okay, here we go. You know what? I'm gonna write them a different way. I like that better. I like that better. Okay, so what I did was I simply wrote them horizontally this time and in a triangle form. I'll give you a hint there. And what I want you to think about is this triangle is a... We're not discovering here for the first time. This is thing's been known for thousands of years. I think the Chinese, the Egyptians may have had it. It's named after a French guy. And that's what you're going to go and you're going to Google. You're going to figure out whose triangle this is given credit to. So it's somebody's triangle. And you're going to figure out how you could have used this triangle to come up with the coefficients that you figured out back up there in number two. So you had to come up with those coefficients, right? Some of them were ones. Pretty straight. The end caps were ones. But the coefficients in the middle probabilities had to do with this. And how you could have used this to figure out the coefficients for any number of chickens, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and above. Because starting in the next day's worth of videos for this, we're going to get into my buddy Mike Smith's flock of 7. And you're definitely going to want to use some kind of a mathematical shortcut to come up with the coefficients you need. Okay, so to recap, figure out whose triangle this is, and figure out how it could have been used to come up with the coefficients that you needed in number 2.